It's March 26, 2024. It's Tuesday. We're here at the World Health Organization in the negotiation on a pandemic treaty. And I'm here with a counselor from the Bangladeshi mission, Kamruzzaman. I'm sure I got that wrong. Can you start by telling people who you are, a little bit about yourself? Just so they know more about you.
Okay, I'm Kamruzzaman, counselor, currently working in Bangladesh Permanent Mission in Geneva.
And you're here in the pandemic treaty. What parts of the agreement are you focusing the most on in terms of?
About focusing on the contents of the treaty, basically from developing country perspective, we would like to see diversification of production facilities, and to enable that diversification, we would like to connect with transfer of technology and know-how, so that it happens in practice. Apart from that, we would like to see also a linkage with market access of the products that will be manufactured by these diversified facilities. In that context, it would be important to link up those designated and identified production facilities with procurement of the products. Currently, it is captured in Article 13.
Oh, that's the supply chain.
Supply chain. Oh.
And I guess there's provisions on the regulatory provisions as well. What would those provisions do?
Okay, on regulatory provisions, you are well aware of that Bangladesh has a small manufacturing base, certainly for accessing the market in the developed countries. The manufacturers have to ensure certain level of quality, safety and efficacy, otherwise they won't be able to penetrate the market. At the same time, we need to keep into account that too much stringent measure can create hindrance. We would like to see the way currently the manufacturers are ensuring the quality is quite well, I should say, but if it is strictly tied up with the international standard, we are afraid the developing country manufacturers won't be able to penetrate the market abroad, because to get that kind of pre-qualification, the manufacturers need to invest a lot. We know there are options for yearly payment of contribution and other measures as well. So these all together can create setbacks. So rather, we would like to see facilitation of developing good standard for ensuring quality in the for the manufacturers in the developing countries.
How do you think the negotiations have gone so far on the topics that you're most focused on?
So far, we see people are keeping to their adamant position, and it is really difficult to proceed from that from the current position if there is no drastic change in the mindset of the developed countries, I should say, because on transfer of technology and know-how. Still, we see dominance of voluntary and mutually agreed terms and conditions. But as a matter of fact, during pandemic and public health emergency of international concern, a certain degree of flexibility would be important to facilitate transfer of technology of know-how. Otherwise, we are perpetuating the status quo. And certainly, that is not the purpose of the current treaty. If we have a flashback, the reason behind conception of the treaty, that people are eager to change the status quo, but in practice currently we don't see any kind of temptation to change that.
What if anything has been the most surprising to you in INB9?
We see still a lot of red lines from both developed and developing countries, but we are really surprised that still people are too much adamant on their red lines. If this is not changed through political commitment, as a matter of fact, we'll not achieve much.
Before I thank you for doing this interview, but before I turn off the video, is there any last thought you want to add?
We would like to see a treaty with actions and deliverables so that it addresses the concern and challenges that we actually faced during the COVID-19 pandemic. This process, we must not allow the process fail. We have invested a lot of energy and time. We have come a long way. We have all the proposals before us now. Let's engage constructively so that we see something that actually serves our purpose.
Thank you very much.